Hello. Oh, Bill, you're outside. Hello.
Hello. Hello, how are you?
Good. Good. So, Geraldine, you're not going to do it now?
No, I'm going to watch.
I'm not doing it now either. I'm doing it later as well.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to watch.
Oh, hi. Hello. Are you doing it now, Harpal? He's still connecting. Hi, Harpal. Are you doing it now? Are you just watching?
Morning.
Morning.
You're giving me the silent treatment.
What's he up to? What are you up to, Harpal?
I'm just trying to make it work, which is what. But we got there now. It took effect to actually start.
Oh, it looks like it is. Look, he's in his garage.
Is that your focused face?
How are you, everyone?
Good.
You? Good, you?
Yeah, all good, thanks.
That's good.
If you're doing it now, have you got a dumbbell?
Yeah.
Perfect. Hello, Anna. A dumbbell. If you've only got a kettlebell's okay.
Lorenzo, you're here.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. You're squinting. You need to put your glasses on. that's what I do when I look at a screen with it. I'm like, that.
Are those new glasses? They look like new glasses.
I don't need glasses. What are you talking about?
I just can't see it.
Yeah, it's probably a good thing.
I want to finish this.
As far as 2016. It feels like,
it's Owen. Oh, is he speaking to Owen?
Oh no, he's talking to a neighbour. Is that loud?
Owen.
Phil, that's not 2 meters.
Owen's got it. Phil's got it.
Yeah. Okay.
So Anna's doing it now. Harpal's doing it now. Phil's doing it now. Awesome. So you've got a dumbbell, because we'll try and get going as quick as we can, just so we can try and get it done in the 40 minutes. And then just for this 90-90 stretch, I said try and find something soft for your knee. If you need to go inside, that's fine. That's like a couch stretch where you put your foot up on the sofa just to get hips talking to the rest of the body. Do you reckon you've got a little space to do your 90-90 stretch? I'll use something soft for my knee.
And if the connection goes bad.
And here.
Let's go out.
So when I do that stretch, I'll try and engage my glutes, and I'll flick my hips back and then try and bring them back through and squeeze my glutes.
Hi everyone.
Is that all good? Mirik, have you got a dumbbell?
Yes, but it's like 21 and a bit, so I'm under RX.
No, that's not a hex. Is it a hex dumbbell?
No, it's not. It's the one with the round plate, so it's not perfect for the deadlifts, because obviously you can't just touch with the front of it, but yeah, that will do. Yeah.
Just for this first bit, because we're going to do some bicep curls to an old song, Bicycle.
I can grab it somehow. So yeah, it'll be fine for the curls. Yeah.
Good stuff. Yeah, we're just going to take hold of the end of the dumbbell. We're going to try and grip it thumbs on top as well. Try and come to a slightly hinged position, and we'll curl every time we hear bicycle. Hi, Shan. You guys have a dumbbell, don't you?
Yeah.
The light. I'm going to come up this side. Might be a bit better. Everyone's hair has started going really crazy colours. A lady just walked past with bright red hair. I saw people with blue and green hair yesterday. Great.
They're experimenting.
Are you next, Sophie? What are you going to colour yours? What colour?
Yeah, I used to be fire truck red. Maybe I will go back.
Oh, yeah, go back to it.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I might go grey.
I think that's a decision. I say be proud of your grey. All right. So, if you're going to play your own music, just mute yourself. Is anyone doing it now that needs my music?
I can go by your music, Soph, if you don't mind.
Yeah. I could do that as well.
Okay. All right, guys, so we're going to set off. So every time, it's really important that we keep the thumbs, try and keep the thumbs on top. Yeah, really spread the fingers apart as you curl the weight up. Okay, we ready? Got our songs?
Sorry, what are we looking at song? Because I've missed the first bit.
I'm going to play you the music.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so every time you hear the word bicycle, you're going to curl the dumbbell towards you. So we're trying to find our biceps, obviously.
Yeah.
Cool.
I get it.
All right. Try and hang on. This is a good, great grip warm-up too. I want to ride my
This is so entertaining.
Sophie, I knew I was going to suggest this song.
You're doing it, Rav.
Oh, there's only one. Look.
Or two. I did with bicep curling. That's it. Keep holding. I'll tell you when. Bicycle. Dean, if you grab your dumbbell. That's it, or a plate, yeah. Try and crush it between your hands. That's it.
Come on, then.
Good luck, girl. Okay, he's singing in the minute. Every time you hear the word bicycle, if you're going off my music, you're going to do a curl. If he's not, you're just going to hold.
Okay, I'll watch Anna.
Yeah, I'm watching Anna, bro.
That's a good idea.
I can't hear it.
If you've just started in, grab a dumbbell, start doing some bicep curls. Hold on, we're not there yet. Hold on, keep those thumbs on top of the hex if you can. Keep the shoulders down. Focus to the biceps. Hang in there. Ready? Off you go. Just try and stop from swinging, really keep it nice and static. Keep it nice and steady.
And that finished.
Can we go straight into Thunderstruck? What a great playlist. Alrighty. So if you're on the call a little bit earlier, you will have seen me do the couch stretch. So we'll just do this. We're going to set a timer off for 90 seconds. So if you've got something soft, you can use for your knee. Going to pop the knee down onto the floor. And keep the foot up on a leg, whatever you've got. So if everyone can find this position. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip my pelvis back and then I'm going to bring it back through again and squeeze my glutes. I'm going to get a stretch up the front of my leg there as well. If having your foot here is too much, you'll come down to the floor and just sit in this lunge position. But you can still practice the changing of the pelvis and squeezing your glutes. So we're going to stick on one side for 90 seconds. Again, if you want to make it slightly harder, you're going to pop your foot up. To make it even harder, you can pull your foot towards your bum. Try and keep the hips forward. Keep facing forward, keep nice and square, squeezing the glute, having a play with the position of the hips. But I want you to try and pull your hips under as if we used to use the analogy of tipping water out back, like bringing your pelvis up and then squeezing your glutes. Rabs, are you going to do this after? Or are you going to do bicep curls?
I'm following. Don't worry about me, but I'm doing it, okay?
30 seconds and then we'll swap sides. Alrighty, swapping sides. So you might find that you've got less flexibility one side. It's generally easier to, if you are going to go from a ledge, to put your foot up first and then almost do a lunge into the movement. So here we're going to pull the hips under, squeeze the glutes. And you can keep switching the tension on and off throughout the 90 seconds. And 1 minute to go. Last little recap. So if this is too much for you, having your foot up on the sofa, you're going to come down onto the floor and just holding. But you can still do the same tensing of the glutes, getting a stretch down the front of the hip flexor too. Last 10 seconds. And then we're going to go and grab, if you used a lighter object for the warm-up, okay, you can rest there. Just this little skill portion, because in the six rounds we are looking for a push jerk, which obviously is a specific movement where you have to dip, dive and drop underneath the object. Option is to do a row or a floor press as well. If you do a floor press, obviously that means you're going to have to hop down on the floor, so it might be that you just do a row to your hip, which I'll go through as well. We're going to just grab a light object if you have one, or the object you're going to use if it's reasonable. Can you guys still see me? Is it too dark?
No, I can see you.
No.
Cool, so I've got my bottle of bleach. What I'm going to make sure I'm doing in my push jerk is that I'm sitting my hips down into my heels, not too far. Keep that middle, keep the weight in the center. I'm definitely not going to let my torso hop, like drop forward. As I go to stand, that's where the weight's going to go. So I'm going to make sure I keep my torso straight. I'm going to drive. And then as I drop, I propel the weight off my body, I'm going to drop to catch it. And then stand up, back down. So if we do this together, if we dip and hold, everybody grabs their object. Cool, so we're going to come to that dip. If we drive, but don't actually extend yet, just dip and see where you can send the weight to. You see how it comes up off my shoulder. We're going to utilize that to then drop back down underneath the object. And then the end of that movement would be to stand it up to come to full extension before we go into our next rep. Okay, if you're not going overhead, the option here is to do a row back towards the hip. Okay, you could potentially make it a bicep curl, just that might be a little bit too much with the hang power cleans as well. So to row it back towards the hip, it's a slightly different movement to you doing the hang power clean. Okay? Somebody having a fight with someone else.
No, I hit the garage door, my bad.
Okay, so what we're gonna do, let's just swap arms if you've not already done that little drill. And I'll stay on the camera so I can see. So if we take the weight to the shoulder, imagine you've just cleaned it up. We're gonna come to a dip position. That's it, so we're corkscrewing the knees. We're gonna try and create that internal tension as well, internal torque in between the thighs. We're gonna drive and then drop underneath the bar or the object, whatever you're using. Good stuff, and then stand it up at the end. Cool, good stuff. Let's do a few of those reps linked together. Because we're cycling the reps here, you might want to keep your feet planted in a set position. So they might have to be wide enough for you to be able to cycle those reps. You don't have to jump and readjust your feet every time. So this little warm-up, we're going to start with three reps of everything. We'll do three rounds. We're going to add one rep each round. So it'll be three deadlift, three hang power clean, three push jerk. I've written this on the comment in the Facebook group as well, this whole warm-up we've done. So if you want to look back at it later, you can do that. After you've done three of everything, go through and do four of everything, then go through and do five of everything. Then we're going to get stuck into doing two rounds of the actual workout. So just quickly, the deadlift. So we're looking for that full extension at the top, sending the hips back as we create that tension in the inner hamstring, touch the ground and then stand up. So it doesn't matter where the dumbbell, if it comes in between your legs or it's to the outside, wherever's comfortable for you. So we'll do three deadlifts, hang power clean. If you've got a dumbbell, my advice would be, especially for a single object, to swing it between your legs and not to the outside of your body. That's probably easier if you've got a double object, but you're gonna bring the weight in between the legs, pop the hips, squeeze the glutes, and get the elbow through. Like we've been doing with kettlebell cleans, we're gonna make sure our lat is switched on so the dumbbell doesn't come really far away from the body. We're gonna get the hips through, squeeze the lats, stack the lats, and get the elbow through. So we've got three of those, and then we'll do our three push jerk. Okay. Don't forget, you're gonna do that on both sides. So 3-3-3, 3-3-3, 4-4-4, 4-4-4, and then 5-5-5, 5-5-5. Good stuff. If you guys start moving, if you're not already. Guys, just while just as they're warming up, there's a couple of people Sarah and Jen. Has anyone got any questions about if they're not using, if you've got an odd object, any questions on how you might change the movement? Obviously, if you want to change any one of these out for something else, like a squat or could be a kettlebell swing, feel free to do that if you need to manipulate the workout for the equipment you've got. Yeah, the important thing is that we're moving, having fun, and still able to take part. Yeah, it doesn't matter if you haven't got that dumbbell or that piece of equipment. Is anybody going to use a kettlebell for the workout? Dino's using kettlebell. Cool.
So yeah, I'm using kettlebell as well.
Cool. Okay, so you'll do a slightly different movement for the kettlebell swing, slightly different technique wise. So yeah, Dino and Lauren, we went through some kettlebell cleans a couple of weeks ago. So the big thing to remember for any sort of kettlebell swing, how important your hips are and using your glutes. My next piece of advice is that same stacking of the lats. So we get the kettlebell traveling close to the body, and then you can just send the elbow through. The last thing we want is it coming away and then crashing back on our body. Our little warm up would be some swings. Yep. Learning to swing it close to the body and then get the elbow through nice and fast. Makes sense with the kettlebell swings. Cool. Jackie, are you all good with the row?
Yeah.
Yeah, the row.
Yeah.
You'll do exactly the same thing instead of going overhead. You could potentially go overhead with the left.
Okay.
Or keep it to a row as well. Up to you. Okay. Cool. So the guys are working through their little warm-up. We started with 3 reps. 3 deadlifts, 3 hand power clean, 3 push jerk. We did that on both sides, and then they added a rep each round. This is all written down as a comment on the Facebook post that Anna put up this morning. It's also going to be where you put your score, and let us know what weight or what object you used as well. Yeah, so if you end up doing it tomorrow, obviously that post won't be too far away. Let us know if you've got any issues getting it done before 8 o'clock tomorrow, we said. Cool. Alrighty, that's the warm-up done. What we're going to go through now is do 2 rounds of the full reps. So we're going to go through and do 12-9-6 on the left arm, 12-9-6 on the right arm. And you'll alternate like that for 6 rounds, the first 6 minutes. So 6 minutes to get those 6 rounds in, and you must alternate between arms in your own time if you want to get going.
I'm guessing 1 round of left hand and right hand.
Nope.
No, so one round.
Yeah. So left, right. 3 on each, yeah.
Yeah, 3 on each. Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah.
And we're still doing warm up now, yes?
And no, I want you to go through and do the actual reps now. So 12-9-6, okay. 1 on the right, 1 on the left. Yeah.
Not to time, this is just as part of the...
Just as part of the warm up, yeah. Nice. Sian's cleans are looking good. She's keeping... keeping the kettlebell, she's probably disagreeing with me, but she's keeping it nice and close so it's not crashing back down onto her body. It should feel quite effortless once you've opened the hips up. If you've managed to use the lat to pull the kettlebell in close, it's just a matter of getting that elbow through with speed. Exactly the same technique we'd use for a bar. You want that fast turn over at the top of the movement.
Harpal's got some nice sound effects going on there, eh?
Sounds like a train, steam train.
Phil, all good? Okay, yes. All those movements. Yeah. So we spoke a little bit on the call last night that the time cap, obviously it's quite a small time cap, the quicker you push through these six rounds, the more rest you're going to get. So we're challenging you, that's why we've named it grip and push. So to grip onto the dumbbell, to not put the object down, to try and keep hold of it for those six rounds, or even if it's just a quick pop on the ground and then go straight into the next round as you switch hands. But it's a competition, so the quicker you get it done, obviously you, if you get it done in 4 minutes and get slightly less reps on the next part of somebody else, you'll score higher in that first round. So you've got an opportunity to score two positions here on the leaderboard. So try and get that first bit done as quick as you can. Your rest, if you finish before the 6 minutes is up, and at 6 minutes, I'll beep you in. And at 6 minutes, we'll go into our max shoulder to overhead. So that's just the last thing I'm going to go over. After you've done your six rounds, for your shoulder to overhead, you can use any shoulder to overhead movement. So you might use a strict press. If you're feeling strong, you might use a push press, so a dip and drive. That's where you don't have to re-dip underneath the object like what we're doing in the workout. You might use a push jerk as well. That's what I did, push jerk. Or if you're really getting tired, you can start by split jerking the reps. But remember, you have to come to that full extended position before you then go into that next rep. Okay. Any questions before we get going? All good?
Are we doing the time or are you doing it for everyone?
I can do it. I was going to do it.
Should we try and set off at the same time?
Yeah. Will it work? It, obviously, if you're doing your own music and things and you want to time yourself, that's fine. But yeah, we can use the WOD timer we did Tabata, didn't we?
You're going to show the time on your screen then so we can see what time we finish if we finish beforehand.
Sorry, what was that?
You're going to put the timer on your screen so we can see what the time is if we finish before the 6 minutes. Or should we do it ourselves then?
I can put a timer up on my screen.
I've got the WOD timer, so I could do it myself.
Stopwatch. I can share my screen to this. Do you want me to share? I can just put my phone in the screen. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Can you see it? Just shout, Harpal. If you're going off my time, just shout time, which is what people do at a lot of boxes. Shout time and I'll take your score down for you.
Okay, cool.
So we're doing, if you're in Tabata, we were going to do 6 minutes of work and we were going to do 2 minutes of rest, but obviously it won't be rest. You'll be moving into your shoulder overhead movements. Okay. Yeah, that might be difficult to see out there. All right, Wadders, are we ready?
Oh, shirt off, shirt off.
All righty, 10 seconds. You'll hear the beeps. Let's go. Let's go get this.
You've only got 6 minutes left on your call.
6 minutes, haha. 6:35. We'll get there. A couple of the people that are timing themselves won't. Yeah, so we've got 4:35 left of the workout. So we'll have just enough time. Perfect.
Time.
Awesome. Because it was on a down time. 3:47.
Yeah.
See you next time.
No. Sorry, kids. Kids boring me.
Oh. Yeah, I think he was timing himself, possibly.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. No probs. Nearly there. If you finish, you're going to be getting ready to move into your shoulder to overhead, max shoulder to overhead in 2 minutes. There's 20 seconds to go.
Ten seconds.
So if you've done those six rounds, you're going to advance into part B. Two, one, off you go. So you're going to count these reps if you're moving into your overhead. You're going to count all these reps. You can swap hands whenever you want. Well done. Try and hang in there. Last 30 seconds. Good stuff, keep going. Nearly there. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Awesome. We've got less than a minute. If anybody wants me to jot down their score, obviously we're gonna lose Sean and Rabs, but they're timing themselves. Anna, I gave you yours.
Yeah.
Harpal, obviously you've got your score.
Yeah, 5 plus 18.
Put it on the comment, Harpal, please.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, pop it on the Facebook group.
Yeah.
We're gonna lose each other. Does anybody want to dial back in? Anyone got any questions or want to talk it out?
What?
Good.
I don't think Merrick heard.
Yeah, we could swap.
Are we finished?
With the push press. The 9 cleans was actually quite heavy.
Yeah, nice, nice work you guys got there. Go on,
do we keep them?
The score?
Yeah.
Pop it in the Facebook group on the post. You're on the Facebook group, aren't you?
I need my time, though. You took my time. I didn't take it.
Oh, that was you shouting. All right. You had 117 left. What's that?
118.
Four.
Is it
183?
Yeah. 43.
And the reps?
Yeah, and then however many reps you did, obviously I wasn't counting those.
Yeah.
No probs. Yeah, and then